61st Street here in the Bronx. MLB The Show's got baseball from Yankee Stadium. Today we've got a contest out of the American League East between the Tampa Bay Rays and the New York Yankees.
And now, your 2021
Yankees baseball comes your way next.
Your Yankees.
Corey Kluber, a right-hander from Alabama, gets the starting assignment. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matty V, this guy lives and dies with one pitch, and that's that powerhouse sinker. Guys often relate it to like trying to hit a bowling ball. When it's good, it's usually at the knees and below, and he's really easy to figure out if he's going to be on. If in the first inning you see a steady diet of ground balls and keeping his infielders involved, there's a pretty good chance he's going to have a rock-solid game.
The 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Our temperature should get us up into the 70s as we move along. 68 at first pitch. The 1-2 misses, ball two. Good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And that misses, ball four. So a good battle to begin the ball game today, but the leadoff man will reach first anyway.
Batting second, the left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
Here's Randy Arozarena. Nobody out, runner on first. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Chopped to third. Tough to get two. He's got to hurry. There's one. Back to first, and he throws it away. And now, oh, this ball's going to wind up out of play. And a big mistake there.
And this is the kind of play that makes a manager go a little bit nuts. It's only the second batter of the entire game, and his defense is throwing the ball around already. I'm sure he's hoping that error isn't a sign of things to come.
Standing in now, Brandon Lau, hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out, but meanwhile the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
That is good. The first baseman, number two, Yandy Diaz.
Next, it'll be Yandy Diaz trying to cash in here in his first at-bat with a runner at third and two gone. Here's the 1-1. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Two-out base runner aboard in the top of the first. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hicks on the move. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. Tampa Bay nothing. Yankees coming up. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Rich Hill will be the starter for the Rays in this one. What do you on him, Danny?
Getting a chance to look at a good veteran pitcher here. This guy's been around the block a few times, but one of the things he does, he still competes at a high level, and he's never stopped trying to learn how to be a good pitcher.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. High in the air into shallow left center. Arozarena comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one.
Batting second, the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton now, his career batting line against Hill. He's 0 for 5. Outside, 2-1. One out, nobody on. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. See you later. over the wall, a home run. A solo home run here off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead. And as we take another look at that one on show track, the story behind that home run was speed and the speed with which it was launched off the bat. Didn't have a ton of height on it, but 113 miles an hour, an impressive exit velocity. To the plate now, Aaron Judge. In there, 2-2. Too high, ball three.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Bases are empty, one man out. Count still full, 3-2.
He's going to be thinking about that pitch all night if he doesn't have a big game right here. Pulled his front shoulder and everything went with it.
Loud contact there, but it's well fouled.
Man, the batter's eyes lit up right there. A hanger just a little bit out in front. Couldn't keep it fair.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Again, another foul ball. One out, nobody on. And he finally wears him down as he strikes him out after a prolonged battle. That was good stuff.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
In now, Luke Voit. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2. Lifted down the line and left. And it's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time.
Wow, these guys are really grinding out their at-bats in this one. They're not making any outs easy to get. And that, of course, is having a huge impact on the pitch count.
And he fouls this one off. And he looks at one that misses. And that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
The 2-1. On a line, that's a base hit into left field. Just an absolute laser that time, screaming off the bat, if you will. And Showtrack tells us it went out at 112 miles an hour. Those are the line drives you can hear as they go by. At the plate now, Gleyber Torres. And this is swung on and missed as the 30th pitch of this inning finally does the trick. The side is retired. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. Second inning coming up. New York off to a 1-0 lead. Second inning set to go, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell. The 1-1. Shot down the line. It's a fair ball. Running hard. He's digging for second. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Now that's the way you answer. They're down 1-0 already, but he laces the double and puts himself in the scoring position. That'll get the dugout fired up and excited to punch back.
So now to the plate, Manuel Margot. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. A runner at second, nobody out. And that misses 2-2. Fouled away. Two-two. Here it is. Again, he sends it out of play. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way, and he lays off. So it's full now. 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Just hung in there on that one. Another full count pitch home. High in the air down the right field line. Oh, what a good at bat with the runner in scoring position as this is into right center. That's a base hit. And the run will score from second as this ball game is tied one apiece.
Boy, what a battle there, D-Row. Several pitch at bat right there. He threw everything but the kitchen sink, and he was still able to get an RBI base hit.
And, Dan, I can't tell you, the longer the ABs go, usually I'll tell you, you get in that swing mode where if he throws the rosin bag, you're pulling the trigger on it. Wait for him to settle in his zone and not come outside of it and end up getting a knock.
A full count to the Rays center fielder. Good battle. Count remains full. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Zunino.
Into the box, Mike Zunino. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Willie Adames will be next. Kluber pauses. Here's the 3-1. There goes the runner. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Batting nine.
Two out, runner in scoring position at second. And up next will be Willie Adames. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. A ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. Now a swing as he shoots this down the right field line. And this is a fair ball as it'll head for the 314 sign. He pulls into second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
Now batting.
And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Stepping in now, Austin Meadows. Count full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. 2 out here and a runner at second. Pulled toward right center field. Hicks is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. So it's 2 runs on 3 hits, no errors and a runner left on. On now to the bottom of the second. The Rays are out in front, 2-1. And now here is Aaron Hicks. The 1-1. Fouled off. And oh, we can't get out of the way of that one. So the leadoff man will be on to open the frame.
Well, this home crowd didn't like this guy in the mound before, but now they really don't like him. He's gotten the faithful all worked up by hitting one of their best hitters early on in this game. And you can bet he's really going to hear it if he comes around to score.
At the plate, Gary Sanchez. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Margo looks up, and this one is gone. A home run. A 2-run home run off the bat of Gary Sanchez. As the Yankees move out in front here, it's now 3-2.
When that pitch was grooved right down Main Street, he couldn't believe it. He started salivating when he saw it, but stayed back enough to put a great swing on it.
To the plate now, Clint Frazier. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Ball 2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Got him swinging in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Frazier is retired and there's one away.
Now batting. The second baseman.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Into the windup and the pitch. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Adames ranging into the outfield. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Into the box now, Giancarlo Stanton. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. Aaron Judge would be next. 2 out, nobody on.
And don't forget, he gave up a long ball earlier in this inning,
right,
so
fielder,
you can understand why he wasn't too aggressive with him there. When he got him to 3-1, he wasn't too anxious to challenge him.
Here's big Aaron Judge, struck out in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Two out with the man at first. Called strike two as he locks him up there. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Grounded back up the middle. Adames picks it up over to first, and that retires the side. The Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. We've played two, and New York has taken a 3-2 lead. Welcome back. Here's Heidi Watney with a report as we get set for the top of the third. Heidi?
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
All right, thanks, Heidi. And now in the box, Randy Arozarena. He comes in 0-for-1 on the day thus far after reaching on an error his first time up. The 2-1 is taken, ball three.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. High in the air out to center field. One away here to begin the third. So next to bat will be Brandon Lau, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
The first baseman,
and that will bring in Yandy Diaz. Fly down in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Third inning, already a 3-2 ball game. And it's fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And another foul ball. High in the air down the right field line. Lays off, 2-2 now.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Swung on and hammered. No doubt about this one. Watch it fly. And that one is gone. On a two-strike count with two away in the inning. So a solo shot down the line in left, and the Rays are back in business now, tied at 3.
Ah, man, that swing right there, Dan, that had to feel good. You're facing an elite starter. You don't know if you're even going to get wood on the baseball today.
You know, and that'll rattle you a little bit. This guy's been throwing the ball great, one of the top pitchers in the game. He's not used to guys barreling him up and hitting him in the seats.
In now, Joey Wendell. Back up the middle. That's through for a base hit. He's now 2 for 2 in this one.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
So now to the plate, Manuel Margot. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Runner on first, two away, all tied at 3 apiece. Hit down the third baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. From the belt, kicks and deals to the left side, but it's well foul. Chopped up the line to first. He's running in the air down the line in left. Frazier finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. One for the Rays on the solo home run. We played 2.5. We're tied now at 3 apiece. And we're back for the bottom of the third. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And one thing he mentioned is how well they're doing at simply putting the ball in play. We looked into the numbers, and as a team, they've had a contact rate of over 85% in this game, meaning that when they swing the bat, they're missing the ball less than 15% of the time. To put that into context, the very best teams in baseball usually are right around 80% for an entire season. So at least for today, they're displaying an amazing ability to put wood to ball.
All right, Heidi, thank you. To two balls and two strikes now.
I can't blame him one bit out on the mound. I'm shocked he didn't pick up the rosin bag and see if he could get a foul ball on that one. He had to see if he would swing way outside the zone.
To short, hit hard. And that'll get on through into left for a leadoff single.
Boy, there's another base hit, and this is just kind of like that gift that just keeps on giving, D-Roll. Both teams piling up the hits, and we're just in the third inning.
Yeah, their ears were open on both sides during the pitcher's meeting today. Good plan at the plate, a lot of execution from the offensive side on both sides.
Standing in now, Gio Urshela. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
And this one's in the dirt, and he will make it back to first, which is probably where he should have stayed to begin with. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Makes the play, one away. Next ahead, Gleyber Torres, 0-for-1 here in the early going.
Torres.
The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's now his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Stepping in once again is Aaron Hicks. He was plunked with a pitch in his first trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
So the bases are loaded here with one man gone. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And he fouls this one off. Here he comes again, 1-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Fouled away, making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. To second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. More from Yankee Stadium in just a moment. Set for the start of the fourth, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. Now the 2-1 pitch. Down the left field line and deep. The 2-2.
You gotta flip down.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. The payoff pitch one more time. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Stepping in next, Mike Zunino. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out.
Now batting.
Next to hit is Willy Adames. He doubled his last time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Fouled off. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Frazier will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. So Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Austin Meadows flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it.
With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it.
Just a sec now as that ball finds its way into the outfield, a base hit. And the run is in to score from second.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. Get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
At the plate now, Randy Arozarena. And all that gets him on the mound. Great support from his infield, though, as that's the third out. Weird way to end the inning. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. Luis Patino, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Number 61, Luis Patino.
Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Two and one. Two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. And it's fouled away. Another try at 2-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Some guys with big arms like this, they're just chuckers. They just throw the ball as hard as they can, and where it ends up isn't that big of a concern, but that wasn't the case there. That was a very well-pitched fastball right on the corner at the knees. Good luck hitting that one.
Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. And he fouls this one off.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
The 1-2. Popped high in the air. And he'll put this away for the second out.
Now that
next will be the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Runs coming fast and furious here. 4-3 our score as we play the fourth. Can't catch the corner away with the fastball. It's 2-1. Called strike two. Here now the 2-2. Hit in the air down the left field line. Arozarena is right there. As he puts this one away, the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They still trail it here 4-3. Michael King, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Michael King.
Ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Brandon Lau. One pitch is a curveball that misses ball two. Some action out in the bullpen, couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Yandy Diaz is on deck. Swing and a miss much too early, and that makes it a full count. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Hicks comes on now, and he has it, one down. Ready now is Yandy Diaz. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. The 1-1 home is taken for ball two. We're in the fifth inning of a 4-3 ball game here. And he misses again, ball three. And that's low, ball four.
Now batting, third baseman, Joey.
And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. The 2-2. Right side, but it's well fouled. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And hey, a strikeout always works too.
At the plate, Manuel Margot. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. Judge gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Rays strand just the one, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Aaron Judge. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. A Rosarena is on the warning track as he hauls it in for a loud out number
now
one.
Batting.
Well, he
first
hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Stepping in now, Luke Voigt. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees first baseman. Three runs, four hits, and one error on the Yankee line score so far. Hit sharply on the ground, and a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one-out base runner.
Hey guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock of the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking we really avoided a worse fate. In now, Gio Urshela. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Standing in now, Gleyber Torres. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count. It just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
So stepping in is Aaron Hicks. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Two men are on with two men out. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And he drops a change in on him there, and that'll run it full, 3-2.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Payoff pitch on its way. Now here's a fly ball. Well hit. Left fielder looking up. And that one is gone! On a two-strike count with two away in the inning. A three-run shot down the line in left, and it's now 6-4.
Yeah, he is kicking himself right now. He worked his tail off to get out of that jam and was one strike away from getting there, and then, boom, all that work goes to waste. From zero damage to a three-run homer in the blink of an eye.
Cody Reed, the 6-foot, 5-inch left-hander, takes over on the mound now. So now to the plate, Gary Sanchez. Hit in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Margot. He's through first and hustling for second. And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double.
The left field.
Just a great approach at the plate right there. Takes that pitch on the outer half and goes with it. He clearly hit it well because it bounced right over the wall for a ground rule double.
At the plate now, Clint Frazier hit down the line at first. The 2-2. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Knee high, he barehands it. Got him. Another look at the big blow for the Bombers. A three-run home run. Through five innings, it's 6-4 New York. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
And it looks like the Yankees will have a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. The 1-2 lifted the other way down the left field line. The next 1-2 pitch. All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. Now another 1-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1 and 2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
Into the box now, Mike Zunino. A 1 and 2 count to the Rays catcher.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that get me over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
At the plate, Willie Adames. Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble, 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And that's in there, base hit.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Row. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
Stepping in now, Austin Meadows. A ball and two strikes.
Don't expect too many more high fastballs in this one. He is known for his sinker, keeping the ball on the ground.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Hits are even at 7 apiece. Swing and a miss at 1 in the dirt. And that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. They trail it here 6-4. So the batting order turns over now and set to go DJ LeMahieu. He's set to start it out for the Yanks here in the sixth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Fouled off wide at first, but boy, that had some zip on it. Still 1-2. Another one sent foul. Another 1-2 delivery. Weakly hit to third. Right to him. No problem here. One away. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go. A solo home run that had him off and running early on. The 1-2. Laid off for ball two. Bases are empty, one man out. Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Up ready with the payoff pitch. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
No right
two away now in the Yankees sixth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here now the 2-2. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, he's digging for second. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Hey, with two strikes right there, he's trying to run that ball up and in to try to tie him up, but it didn't quite work out.
Yeah, in today's game, everybody's fighting so hard to keep their hands inside the baseball that I think a non-executed pitch on the inner half, Dan, is exactly what the batter's looking for, something he can keep his hands inside and just fist to the opposite field.
And it looks like they'd rather go after the next guy as the intentional walk signal comes here with two away.
Well, they felt it was better to take the bat out of the hands of a guy like that. He's just too dangerous, and they decided they'll take their chances with the next guy in the lineup.
Striding in is Gio Urshela. Lifetime against this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0-1. The 1-1 misses for the second ball.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Ready with two balls and a strike. Change up, called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Line to left. And that's in there. Base hit. And they'll add one more to the total as the score moves to 7-4 now.
Hey, there's a good job of battling right there, D-Lo. Pitcher had the advantage with two outs, two strikes. You're one pitch away, and boy, what a terrific piece of hitting right there.
Yeah, that's a great job right there. Some guys are not afraid to hit with two strikes. They'll take that pitcher deep in the count, feeling comfortable about it. That's the type of hitter this guy is, and he was able to come through.
Into the box, Gleyber Torres. All even now, 2-2. Two down, runners at first and second. Hit out towards second. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second. That makes it an 8-4 ball game.
You know what I like right there, Dan, is the batter's approach. Not trying to do too much, just taking it right back up to shoot again, staying within himself, and just knowing that anything to the outfield gets him an RBI.
Well, that's a good piece of hitting. That's a great point, D-Lo. I think a lot of times hitters go up there trying to do a little bit too much. Sometimes you just have to go ahead and hit the ball where it's pitched, and a good job, and a run batted in.
Aaron Hicks will stand in as he's accounted for one of the biggest at-bats of the game so far. A three-run shot back in the fifth that's really energized his ball club. Hit in the air down the right field line. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Seventh inning coming up. The Yankees are out in front, 8-4. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Randy Arozarena. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Slow little roller to third. Gonna be a tough play. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. And stepping in, Brandon Lau, not providing much out of the three hole in this one. Hitless in three at bats so far. The 1-2. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him. And I doubt there was any intent behind that.
Yeah, I can hear the crowd murmuring now, wondering if he hit him on purpose. But hey, us pitchers need to be able to throw inside, especially when facing hitters as dangerous as he is. Pretty sure this one just got away from him. And hey, that's part of the game.
And now, Yandy Diaz. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Two balls and a strike to the Rays first baseman. Weak grounder down the line at third. Reined in. LeMahieu for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Rays held in check here. They're unable to make a dent in an 8-4 deficit. Andrew Kittredge will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
For Tampa Bay, number 36, Andrew Kittredge.
Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. One-one. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And action now in the Tampa Bay pen as it looks like a right-hander's begun to get loose. Here now the 2-2.
That was a changeup, so there really wasn't. It looked to me like it just slipped out of his hand a little bit. That'll happen sometimes because of the grip of that straight changeup.
Now the payoff pitch home, and that misses ball four. It's a leadoff walk to start the home seventh.
The batter, the left fielder, Clint.
So here is Clint Frazier. He bounced out last time up. A runner at first with no outs here. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Now batting, second baseman, DJ.
Next to dig in, DJ LeMahieu. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
To second for one. On to first, a double play.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
So now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. Swing and a miss, strike two. Men on third with two down. Swing and a little tapper. He stays alive, still two and two. Has a look, now the pitch. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. A ball that's carrying. And he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. The Yanks leave one. They still lead it by a count of 8-4. Ready to begin the eighth, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Now a ball ripped into deep center field. Hicks has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Next, it'll be Manuel Margot. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. To 1-2 now. Four runs, seven hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Fouled away. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Hit hard on the ground towards second. LeMahieu's got it. Throw in time at first for route number two. So here's Kevin Kiermaier, two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
Three, two pitch. Swing and a line drive. But a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field for the final out of the inning. Down in order go the Rays. They're unable to make a dent in an 8-4 deficit. Now to the plate, Aaron Judge. He came across to score after doubling in his last at-bat.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Got him to chase out of the zone that time.
Now
Aaron Judge sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning.
Boy.
In now, Luke Voit. Down low, two balls and a strike. Into the corner and slicing foul. One out, nobody on. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. The 2-2 one more time. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days. But it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Into the box now, Gio Urshela. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Trying to shave that outside corner with the fastball, and he missed it. It's 3-1 now. Gleyber Torres would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Hit back up the middle. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And no chance at all to make a play here, so despite the effort, the inning will continue.
Now batting.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, Dealer, in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job, but any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Yankee shortstop behind in the count 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. One left for the Yankees. They still lead it by a count of 8-4. Jonathan Loaisiga comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 43, Jonathan. Loaisiga.
All set to start the ninth in this one, and next will be the power hitting catcher, Mike Zunino. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Boy, oh boy, that's a tough one for the pitcher. He's definitely wondering, where the heck was that pitch? I think he called it high, but our strike zone says otherwise.
Next up is Willy Adames. His career numbers in this matchup, he's a perfect 3-for-3. He also has one home run. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Struck him out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Standing in now, Austin Meadows. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
The 1-2 pitch. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball, so that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
Up next, Randy Arozarena. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Here's the 1-1 pitch, and he lays off for a ball. 2-1.
Good fastball there. Didn't get the swing, but the guy at the plate isn't someone who chases many bad pitches.
And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. Hicks is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Hey, one of the keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home, so this was a big win to win at home in front of their home crowd.
8-4, the final this afternoon. So the Bronx Bombers used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Michael King takes home the win. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Yankees, 8 runs on 11 hits.